Hello, I'm Mariana Danilovich with Ultra Live TV, and we're here at Digital Hollywood Fall 2010 with Michael Kassan. With Michael Kassan, I'm so sorry, with MediaLink. Hello, Michael.
Hello, how are you?
I'm great, how are you?
Couldn't be better, although the sun could be shining. It's LA, I mean, we're not supposed to have rain here.
We ordered the rain so we can interview everyone.
Absolutely.
So you had this wonderful branded integration panel with executives from all the relevant areas of the space. What would you say is the takeaway from this panel?
That we're still in the early days of this iteration, and in fairness, the level of adult supervision that's required for success in any business enterprise, I think, is really underscored in the integration and branded content and development business, because there's going to be a lot of efforts, some which will fail, some of which will succeed, and some of which we haven't thought of yet. But so long as you keep a steady hand and you understand, I think, what the panelists said, which, at least from an advertiser's perspective, the most important thing is driving sales. It's all about brand building. It's all about cool, hip, new things. But at the end of the day, the metric, I think, would be another big learning, is going to relate to what happens on the shelves if you're selling a product, or at the cash register if you're selling a service or whatnot. So I think that's the big takeaway from this morning.
So interestingly enough, you've been in this space of branded integration for longer than it existed, right? You were kind of the proponent of it being made. And so I can date it back to maybe 2002 when the first product placement kind of, you know, stop being just product placement.
See, I stole a line from one of the real leaders in our industry, a guy by the name of Bill Crosdale, who I had the privilege of working with back at Western International Media. And as we were addressing the Y2K phenomena, Bill would always say, I don't understand what all this noise about Y2K is. Y1K was an easy transition. So I've been there since Y1K. So I'm not sure there's anything new here.
So you don't think we put a stake in the ground in 02? It could have been 10 years before.
Yeah, I think it's probably back to the way I think I heard it in Venice when the original glass manufacturers and glass blowers, they were doing product placement back then, and in the Grand Canal and
putting Murano on it.
Exactly. So I think it's that line, everything old is new again. I think that's sort of what we're experiencing, just with a lot more fragmentation.
I just didn't know Murano was a textile. So the question for you is, remembering the earlier days of this decade of branded integration, the actual integration with television and features, and now transmedia integration, how much of those dollars are going to other media than film and TV?
I think, an increasing percentage. I mean, you can't get a hard quote from anybody, but I think it was Peter Tortorici on the conversation who said, it's not necessarily a lot of new money, it's just money being reallocated. And I think the percentage continues to increase. You hear numbers of 10%. I think that the number is probably, far larger than that. But I think we're going to just see it continue to grow, as you say, using the transmedia or the cross-platform conversation as a base. So I think it's going to continue to grow.
And then the size of the market question. So we started, I think, two, and maybe we tracked the first billion of branded integration and then the first 10 billion. And where are we now in tracking the size?
Well, I think that what I would do there is, as a final note, just proving how old I really am, I would go back to the Garden of Eden and that first moment when Adam and Eve started to get amorous one another, and Adam said to Eve, you better stand back. I don't know how big this thing's going to get.
Thank you, Michael.